And
ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's main event time and pause for us.
Yes, it is.
The following contest is scheduled for one fight, and it is a six-man tag, Monsters Ball Match.
This is not going to be a pretty thing to look at. This, as I mentioned, is going to be a brutal confrontation between six brave men who are entering this street fight-like environment, and in comes the master of the beasts, the head of the Beast Cartel, Rico de la Vega, leading his army into battle, who, as you can see, is dressed for a fight. Well, whether you love the Beast Cartel or hate them, whether you love their opponents or hate them, these men are about to embark on one of the most brutal matches you will ever witness, and certainly, I dare say, one of the most brutal matches that the MFPW inside the world-famous Monster Factory will have ever witnessed. And you see one of the teams, the Freak Beast, Nick Comoroto, Kyle the Beast, and Fallah Bahh, about ready to do battle against two members of the Real Life Heels, Matthew Riddle, the Punisher Martinez, the heavyweight champion of the MFPW, and the Monster Abyss. And when I tell you this is going to be physical, I think at the end of this, you might not be able to tell the winners from the losers. That's just my thought. And here come their opponents. Well, look at this. They've come prepared. They got a cart full of tools of the trade, as it were.
Representing the Real Life Heels at a total combined weight of 464 pounds, they are the Keystone Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions, Matthew Riddle, and the MFPW Heavyweight Champion, Punisher!
Yep, there they are. The Real Life Heels making their way to the ring with a cart, a green cart, I might add, of some weapons, as I like to say, some weapons of mass destruction. There you go, the team. And they are awaiting on their teammate, the biggest monster of them all, the Monster Abyss, who's about to make his way out here right now. Oh, boy. There he is. Oh, and he's breaking down right now. Stuart Campbell, you best get out of that ring as fast as you can, brother. It is breaking down. The Monster's Ball is underway. And it's going to be a tough one to call. We're just going to let you see it as we are. You got six guys in there, and this is going to be a street fight. We're going to try to call it as best as we can. As I mentioned before this thing started, at the end of this, it might be hard to tell the winners from the losers. And Stuart Campbell, it's breaking down already, this street fight, this Monster's Ball.
Really, I couldn't tell.
Oh, no, I was cheering you on. I said, Buster, you better get out of that ring as quick as you can.
Yeah, well, I'd like to think that I did. Somehow
you did great. You made it back here in one piece, brother.
To find one piece.
Well, there'll be no peace in this match, that's for sure. This is all-out war. Boom! The real life heels now, ruling the roost, so to speak.
That is what, that's part of what made them the Keystone Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions. They are an accolade that they earned a few months back, actually. Our good friends out in Lancaster running that particular promotion, and there goes.
As I mentioned, it's going to be a tough one to call. There's going to be action all over the place. We're going to let you watch it as we try our best to call it here for you, ladies and gentlemen.
Absolutely. Monster's Ball, if you're not familiar with it, a match that the Monster Abyss originated himself.
That's right.
And basically the rules go like this. If you can conceive it, you can do it.
Yep. And if there's a weapon you can bring to the ring, you can use it. About as legal as a headlock. As now, it looked like Punisher Martinez, and I couldn't see who went over there, who he went over there with, but they are going to the other ring that they use for training here at the world famous Monster Factory. We cannot see them right now.
This is amazing.
Right now, we have. Oh, there we go. Oh. It looks like we got two rings worth of action here, Stuart Campbell. Punisher Martinez, and it looks like Kyle the Beast, who faced off.
Oh, in the other ring,
Yeah, we got double ring action here, brother. We got Nick Comoroto and Matthew Riddle in the ring closest to you. And in the far ring, Punisher Martinez and Kyle the Beast. Abyss has Fallah Bahh on the far side of the ring in front of you. John Gazzardo over in the far ring with Punisher and Kyle the Beast. A swinging sabot kick by Matthew Riddle. Nick Comoroto, the Freak Beast.
Oh my goodness. And see the quality that you see in this matchup. Punisher Martinez with a heavy right forearm. Punisher Martinez versus Kyle the Beast was a heavyweight title match not too long ago.
Yes.
Matthew Riddle trying to reclaim his lost MFPW heavyweight title from Nick Comoroto, who was at the time champion. That was a title match. And we're seeing these things at the same time, but whereas those matches might have come down to technical acumen here.
Well, we got some hardware, Stuart.
Oh,
Punisher Martinez just got a ladder from where, I don't know, but he's taking it into the far ring.
Talking about the knees that Matthew Riddle just gave to Nick Comoroto. My goodness. This is bad news.
Yeah, we knew it was going to be physical. We got Punisher Martinez over with Kyle the Beast in the far ring and a ladder. And he goozles him, maybe a choke slam by Punisher Martinez. And now we got the, I guess you call that the dude lock by Matthew Riddle on the huge arm of Nick Comoroto. Pinfalls only. Will a winner be determined in this, Stuart Campbell? And brother, when you got an arena full of action, you got two rings. This one, again, as I mentioned, it may be hard to tell. The winners from the losers.
Oh,
somebody just went into the ladder.
That was Punisher.
Well, you live by the ladder, you die by the ladder, I guess, in some sorts.
You're absolutely right. And oh my goodness, where even is either Fallah or
Rico de la Vega running around here at ringside. Abyss over there with Kyle the Beast, they're going at it. We knew it was going to be wild. And I fear we're just getting started with this.
Kyle the Beast and the Monster Abyss engaging each other. Right by the entranceway to the MFPW arena.
Looks like the Beast Cartel of Fallah Bahh and Nick Comoroto with a...
What the hell is that? Right to the gut.
That's a beer keg.
Oh, man.
Well, anything goes. Sticks, bricks, bottles, chains, I guess beer kegs. Whatever you got, it's legal.
I heard that they were going to try to offer Abyss a beer. I did not think that's what they meant. I thought it was some sort of a peace treaty or, oh my goodness.
Yeah.
There is nothing beautiful about this. You're absolutely right.
It's breaking down and getting nasty and Fallah Bahh. I don't know who he just nailed over there. It was out of my vantage point.
You saw it at home, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure.
Well, you could hear it clear over here.
Oh, yeah. You could hear that clear across the neighborhood. You kidding me?
I believe that may have been Matthew Riddle. I'm not sure. Again, we can't see everything going on over there. We're trying our best here. Abyss now coming up to the ring apron. Fallah Bahh coming around here to the shopping cart and the trash can with the tools of the trade, if you will. He's got some implements coming into the ring now.
Oh, wow.
Trash can lid.
Some trash left in it, apparently. Oh, no. What? This one has a lot more than just paper in it.
We got some sticks. Kendo sticks. What in the world does Rico de la Vega have?
That's a stick covered in barbed wire.
Oh, boy. This is getting nasty. This is getting nasty.
Oh
man, they broke that barbed wire stick over the back of Abyss. Fallah Bahh just...
Oh, there's the freak beast with a chair. Watch out!
Oh, that'll crack some ribs.
Goodness gracious.
Monster's ball, Stuart. This thing is just a glorified street fight. This is all out war. Oh, off the head of the Monster Abyss. Nick Comoroto with that trash can, denting it into the skull of the Monster Abyss.
If anyone has a gripe, a rightful gripe with the Monster Abyss, it is, in fact, the freak beast Nick Comoroto.
Oh, Stuart, this is not going to be pretty. Oh, man. A bat off a trash can lid off the groin of Matthew Riddle. For the love of God.
Well, like any good player swung right through the ball.
I reckon you're right there, but man, oh man. Oh! What is that, a cookie sheet?
Yeah.
It's got a cookie sheet. Kyle the Beast with a chair over the back of the champion, Punisher Martinez. This can't be good. Oh man.
That is a straight headshot.
Yeah. No hands to protect. He took that right off the skull. And I'll tell you what, this can't possibly be good for the champion to be involved in a match like this. You got title defenses to look forward to, but he's in this thing. And Matthew Riddle has got a can over his torso. Oh, and he runs into Fallah Bahh with a clothesline.
Good idea for John Gazzarda to clear the bat out of the ring. Clearly it was dangerous.
I believe we have a commode lid over the neck, over the head of the Monster Abyss by Fallah Bahh, brother. They are just pulling out all the stops here in this Monster's Ball main event.
I mean, I want to say everything but the kitchen sink, but I feel like they'll pull out a kitchen sink.
Or everything but the commode lid at this point. But yeah, you're right. We might actually see that before night's end here.
Goodness gracious.
The Freak Beast now with Matthew Riddle, Fallah Bahh with the commode lid. Oh, man. Over the back. This is just mayhem.
There are so many dynamics at work here in this Monster's Ball match. I mean, you talk about the real-life heels, their former involvement with Rico de la Vega,
yep,
under which he managed Matthew Riddle's heavyweight title reign, as well as QT Marshall and Punisher Martinez, and then they cast him out.
Yep.
Rico de la Vega, this is all personal,
yes,
for Rico
it is.
De la Vega.
Oh, man!
Oh, my goodness!
Punisher Martinez into the chair!
He assembled the Beast Cartel for this very reason, to punish the real-life heels, to
get revenge on the kendo stick
to Matthew Riddle, to get
revenge
on his former champions. And you see Nick Comoroto, the Freak Beast, Kyle the Beast, and Fallah Bahh standing tall in the middle of the ring, and it looks like they're not done.
Now the Beast Cartel ruling the roost right now. This is mayhem. This is the most physical battle that I personally have ever had the opportunity to eyewitness firsthand. He's got that kendo stick around his neck. Oh, Riddle kicks him off. Here's your MMA training right there. Oh, the kendo stick. Man, he is swinging the stick, baby. Home runs abound.
The Beast Cartel are in deep waters now. Here comes Matthew Riddle.
Oh, man, we got sticks flying here. This is physical, ladies and gentlemen. A chair shot to Kyle the Beast by the champion, Punisher Martinez. Oh, man, you can hear that all the way over here.
That'll leave a mark.
You can better believe that. It'll leave a lot of marks. Man, this is just utter mayhem here in the MFPW arena.
You know, it's certainly hot outside, about 90 degrees here today.
Brother, I know where you're going. It's hot as in here, isn't it? Good grief.
You have no idea.
Woo.
Oh, my goodness, Matthew.
Over the top. Oh, my God. My God, he took out the Beast Cartel.
This is a side of Matthew Riddle that we simply have never seen before.
A beast, I might say.
What has gotten into the real-life heels?
Fallah Bahh with a clothesline. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we knew this was going to be hard to call. This is just absolute legalized mayhem.
There's Martinez the timekeeper's table. And
well, you can better believe if it's around this arena, it could be used for anything at any time. Fallah Bahh now with Abyss on the far side of the ring. Man, this is just mayhem. For six big men like this to hammer each other. No. Fallah Bahh, what is he doing? Oh, man. A chair to the back of Fallah Bahh.
He turned his back.
Oh, he goes with him. Oh, he chokeslammed him. My God. Abyss just chokeslammed Fallah Bahh. I don't even know what was over there. Off the ropes, through onto the floor.
Right through the table. Right through the table that the Beast Cartel themselves set.
Oh, my God. Man, I'll tell you what. Well, these six men.
No.
Oh, boy. Well, I have a feeling we see another bag. I dare say, I don't think there's Skittles in that bag, Stuart.
Oh, no. I don't think so either.
Thumbtacks. And what is he doing? The last time he was in the ring with Abyss, Rico de la Vega ended up on thumbtacks.
No.
Are you serious? Come on, Rico.
Rico de la Vega, meet the
spear! And I think Abyss landed in the tacks. I think Abyss's arm landed in the tacks. Into the corner. Oh, boy.
Oh.
Riddle. Got him hooked. Fisherman suplex. Down! Matthew Riddle has turned into a beast himself. The freak beast misses with a clothesline. Uh-oh. Up he goes. Comoroto now. He has countered. He's got him up. Ooh! What GTS.
Beautiful maneuver. Oh,
there are thumbtacks in the ring. Comoroto on his feet now. Here comes Punisher Martinez. He's got him by the throat.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
South of heaven!
I thought he was going down on attacks, Stuart, sorry. Choke slam. Oh!
And Punisher Martinez hit with his very own finishing maneuver.
We got a lateral press.
This
no!
Is-
oh! My God, I thought that was it. Can you imagine being beaten with your own finishing maneuver? My God.
Punisher Martinez, I'm not sure what's keeping any of these men up right now, but you're absolutely right. Maybe it was pride. Maybe it was just sheer grit, but Punisher Martinez.
Survival tactics, brother. It's the will to survive now.
You're absolutely right. And talk about survival of the fittest. This might be survival of the craziest here in Moss's Ball.
Well, Nick Comoroto now, he's got some chairs. Throwing them in the ring on top of thumbtacks. Man, this thing is crazy.
This is Monster's Ball Build, yeah, right?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. We knew it was going to be physical. We knew it was going to be brutal. But, man, Stuart, I...
Could we have imagined this?
No,
I
never.
I certainly could not have.
I mean, this is pain and agony. I mean...
The humanity. Oh, the humanity in this match. And Nick Comoroto.
What is he thinking here? He's got four chairs set up in the ring, and I doubt it's for a sit-down meeting. Right hand on the champion.
Oh, no! Oh, this is two big men going up to the top.
This is Comoroto. Not going to be pretty.
Comoroto is 275 pounds.
Nick Comoroto, he's got him front face lock. Are we going to see a superplex?
The man to whom he lost his title. Look out below.
Oh, my God. Look out. Oh, my God. He caught him. Oh, my God. He countered. Powerbomb. Yes. Through the chairs. Punisher Martinez with a powerbomb through four chairs.
I can't believe he lifted him.
Unbelievable. Well, I'll tell you something. I said at the outset, it may be hard to tell the winners from the losers when this thing's all said and done. They are literally beating the high holy hell out of one another.
And if you heard that crowd before chanting, this is awesome. Folks, I have to say that I'd use a couple other adjectives to...
Brutal, sickening, vile.
Absolutely. Those being among them, but oh my goodness.
Kyle the Beast from all.
Thus far, I'd say awesome is absolutely among them as Kyle the Beast. Absolutely brutalizing Punisher Martinez in the corner. Oh, man.
He's going for a rolling maneuver into the corner, but...
Caught a knee to the face.
Yep. Oh, he caught him. He caught him.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. Ooh. Slams him down. Oh, and moonsault off the second rope. John Gazzardo down for the cover. Man, you almost want it to be over. I mean, really? How much more can they take?
I don't know. This is a match that is known to shorten careers. A match that is known to put people out for months.
Yep.
A match, quite frankly, this is where Abyss feels at home, so it's probably smart for the Beast Cartel to target people other than Abyss because he's so familiar
with
this
match. Wait a
minute.
Wait, Stuart. The Beast just went outside. He's going underneath the ring. What in the world are we going to get next? What the? Got it. What's he getting? I can't see from my vantage point here. What does he have?
Oh my goodness.
Wait a minute.
There's no way. They have
Oh my God, that is a table wrapped in barbed wire. Are you kidding me? This thing has gone off the page, man.
Oh, it has been well off the page long before this, but now.
Yeah, well, you know, you see the little youngsters around here covering their eyes. That's a smart move.
Folks, if you are weak in the stomach.
Or weak at heart. Yep.
Absolutely. You might want to turn away now if you haven't already.
Yeah. Yeah, this is not going to be pretty. That is a table with barbed wire attached to it. You got to believe that the diabolical mind of Rico de la Vega is behind that. Intent on destroying anything in the path of his cartel, that's got to be from the diabolical mind.
Not only, his face right into the table. Not only for his cartel, but against the real life heels.
Oh, the rubs. Oh, he got caught by Abyss. He's got caught by Abyss. Got him attacks. God, the Beast went down on those thumbtacks. For God's sake.
I can't believe it.
Oh, my God. Oh, the curb stomp into the chair.
Wait a second.
Riddle going up to that top turnbuckle.
He trying to get up. Oh no.
Oh my God.
Oh no. Kyle, the Beast is in deep trouble.
He's
Matthew
up.
Riddle.
He's up. Big splash. Frog splash by Riddle. It's over. Mercifully, it's over. My God.
The winners of this match, the Monster Abyss, Punisher Martinez and Matthew Riddle, the Riddle.
Unbelievable. This match. Kendo sticks, barbed wire, tables. I'm almost speechless, and that's tough for me.
The punishment that these six men went through, almost unspeakable. We could not put it into words.
Nope.
You saw it for yourself. You saw it with your own eyes here on the MF Network.
Thumbtacks, barbed wire, trash cans, shopping carts.
Unspeakable horrors.
Oh, I'm telling you.
These six men went through.
Stuart, one of the most physical battles that I think you and I personally in this arena have ever eyewitnessed just took place in this ring. Six of the bravest souls to ever compete in this ring, just laid it on the line for you. Respect to all six men.
It's amazing the punishment that these six put each other through. But at the end of the day, it is the real life heels, Punisher Martinez and Matthew Riddle, alongside the Monster Abyss, that got the job done.
Unbelievable. And when Kyle the Beast hit those tacks, my God, there's your victors right there. They went through hell and back, but I'll tell you something, they're the victors.
The sick freak that came up with this match, the Monster Abyss, fought alongside Matthew Riddle and Punisher Martinez with really no real reason to do so. He lost his title to Punisher Martinez. He could have very well have turned on the real life heels right here and now.
Now they
this
had a
was
common
for pride.
Enemy.
Yep. He wanted to win his own match.
Yep.
He wanted to take the Beast Cartel into his home, into the depths of hell. He led them in to the Monster's Ball, and he came out victorious.
Yes, he most certainly did. No question about that. They had a common enemy in the Beast Cartel, and There are still thumbtacks in that ring.
Okay, take your time. We've been through a lot here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. It's been an amazing night, capped off by perhaps the most brutal, most physical, most volatile display
we have
ever seen in professional wrestling and likely could ever see again within the confines of the MFPW.
And Stuart, they are walking away, and the fact that they are actually walking from this ring is a shock to me. I mean, after what we just witnessed, it is a testament to them, and they're walking away. Wow. The fact that anybody in this match can walk is a shock to me. Well, Stuart Campbell, this has been one of the most memorable nights that I personally have ever been a part of, and I gotta say, this is the MFPW, and it just does not get any more physical than what we've just seen here tonight.
Everybody, give it up! Wow! Come on, everybody! We got cards everywhere! Unbelievable. Matthew Riddle, Punisher Martinez, let me borrow you guys for a second before everybody wakes up. Everybody, give it up for the real life heels. And these guys have been on a tear like no other. Punisher Martinez, the MFP heavyweight champion. Matthew Riddle everywhere. We got a show coming up June 11th. Matthew Riddle. Punisher Martinez, heavyweight title match.
What? Wait.
Matthew Riddle versus Punisher Martinez. Who wants that? Who wants to see these two go at it? I know I do.
Teammates? Did we just hear that right?
Friends fight all the time. Friends fight all the time. I want to see it.
Well, I guess
we got ourselves a deal.
Yeah, I guess.
June 11th, Matthew Riddle versus Punisher Martinez for the MFPW Heavyweight Championship.
Wow.
There's a blockbuster for you, brother.
Absolutely. We saw this before. Punisher Martinez versus Matthew Riddle. In fact, Matthew Riddle began his reign as MFPW Heavyweight Champion.
Sorry, but we got to clean all this up, and we got to get these guys some medical help.
Yeah.
Everybody just get to the back and get some people to help out, and we got to clear out. I'm sorry, guys. If it was any other night, we'd do the tour and everything. We'll take care of it June 11th. This is real ugly here. Thank you, everybody.
Well,
you heard it from him,
June
11th. June 11th.
Matthew Riddle.
He said it better than I ever could.
June 11th, it's going to be Matthew Riddle challenging his teammate, Punisher Martinez, for the heavyweight championship here in the MFPW. After what we just saw here tonight, I don't know how it could get any better, but brother, that is a main event anywhere in the world, what those two face up on June 11th.
You're absolutely right, and I can't wait to call it alongside you if I am so fortunate.
Likewise, my friend, and for Stuart Campbell, for Danny Cage, and for all of us here at the MFPW, this is Bill Knight saying good night, everybody.
Goodness gracious.
I have a headache.
Yeah.
Like, my head is going like this.